the Loon. I'm Chris.
And I'm Wesley.
The Greek God Loon.
Ooh, yes. The Greek God Loon.
I'm doling out the compliments today. Let's do it. Hey, you are in my book.
Yeah,
so anyway, we are doing one of our all-time favorite dishes. It's a sandwich of sorts.
It's so good.
Exploding with flavor. We are doing our
best ever chicken gyro. Well, a lot of people say gyro.
I've always just called them gyros.
But the correct pronunciation is gyro.
Okay, thank you.
I guess you could spell it phonetically with a Y-E-E.
Gyro. Yeah. You are my hero, gyro. So anyway, we're doing it.
It's amazing.
It is super amazing. So this is chicken. Often you can get lamb gyros, which are fantastic too, but this is a little healthier version, and I'm telling you, we're not skimping on flavor whatsoever.
No way. So you probably
see this is beautifully marinated chicken. Let me tell you how I did this. I started off with 1.5 pounds. I think it's about 8 boneless, skinless chicken thighs. That chicken thigh, it's dark meat. It's so flavorful. It grills beautifully. Mm. And what I did was I just very lightly, I like to season all of the different layers. So I do a light layer of salt and then a layer of pepper. And then we flip it over and salt and pepper it again. Okay, now I'm going to move that to the side. Now we're going to make this marinade. So we're going to start off with 1/4 cup of whole milk Greek yogurt. Greek yogurt, of course. Now, I just love whole milk yogurt because the flavor just is unbeaten.
So
but you
delicious.
Can certainly even make this lighter and go with low-cal, low-fat, or even non-fat. But, you know, it's a little bit. It's not a whole lot. So go with the
whole milk. Yeah, and you're just marinating.
You're just doing a little marinating. So anyway, okay. So then to that, now help me here, Luke.
Yes.
To that, we're going to add three cloves of garlic that have been finely minced.
Yeah.
We're going to dump that in. And then we're going to add 1 tablespoon of red wine vinegar. And then we're going to add 1 tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
And then to that, we're going to add some seasonings. I've got some wonderful, a teaspoon of smoked paprika and 1 teaspoon of ground coriander.
Yes.
Love it. And then we're going to, this is a really quintessential, spice is oregano in Greek cooking. So I do 1 tablespoon of dried oregano. And then to that, we add a healthy pinch of salt, about 1/2 teaspoon, and then another pinch of black pepper. Okay, and now we're going to use a whisk, and we're going to whisk all
mix
of that
up,
and we're going to mix it up. And then we're going to transfer that chicken, seasoned chicken, into a large glass bowl, and then we're going to dump the marinade over there. And then we're going to remember, oops, I forgot to add lemon juice. So it's no big deal. We're going to add the juice of 1 whole lemon into the bowl. Obviously, you could have done that when we're making
when
marinade,
mixing the marinade.
It all goes to the same
That's
place.
That's all
so
right.
It's really no
That's
big deal.
That's fine.
There's one thing that you could have probably done at the last. It's the lemon because
juice.
That helps just really permeate that meat and get flavorful. So then what we do, then I just get a nice, you don't have to do this, but I love doing this. I just think it's easier. I get a nice large zipper bag, and then I transfer that very carefully. It's kind of hard to do. It's helped to get your goddess.
Your Greek god.
Your of a loon to help you. And then you just transfer that in there and then pour all of the excess juice in there, get the air out, zip it up, and then put it in the fridge for at least 1 hour because that's really going to make this thing so flavorful. You can do it up to 8 hours overnight is perfectly great. Don't let it go like 12, 14 hours. Then it starts to affect the chicken.
Got it.
Okay.
Got it.
I've talked a lot.
I just realized that our neighbors are Greek, the Paris Kavopoulos. They'll love this.
I hope.
How does that? That just rolls off the tongue. The Paris Kavopoulos.
It took us 2 years to get to be able to say that. Okay.
So let's talk about this amazing.
We've got the grill fired up. And
right.
So we've got this. There's a topping, a salad topping that we put in with this. So tell us how we do.
And it's cucumbers and all this deliciousness. Cucumbers are like my favorite thing in the world. All right. So we've got. This is 1 whole cucumber that you have taken off the skin, and then you took out all the, you cut it in half, you took out all the seeds, and then you cut them in these little pieces here.
You know, I don't like too giant, and I didn't take all of the skin off. I laid a little bit just for decoration, and that's 1 cucumber.
And then about 1/2 cup of... Chopped tomatoes.
I love to get grape or cherry tomatoes and just give them a rough chop.
You can certainly
use 1 whole tomato too.
Yep. And then a small red onion.
That's about 1 cup of a chopped red onion.
So good.
These flavors just meld so beautifully.
And then some parsley. How much is that?
That's 1/4 cup of freshly chopped parsley.
Got it.
Right along. The loon
and
is
now we've got some
cooking.
Vinegar. Is this red wine vinegar?
That's red wine vinegar.
And that's a tablespoon?
Tablespoon of red wine vinegar.
Look at me.
I know. It's almost like you know what you're doing.
And then some pepper.
About a quarter teaspoon.
And then some salt.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay.
And then I'm going to mix this all together.
Yes.
And as I mix this together,
I'm going to go put this on the grill. So this can absolutely be made in advance. Obviously, the marinade and the marinating of the chicken can be done in advance. Once you start rolling on this, it comes together quickly.
This okay. with the chicken in the forget about it.
All right, we'll be back. We got a few more secrets to show you.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited.
I get so thrilled about this.
It smells delicious.
It smells incredible, and we're so close. So let's talk about this amazing meat. I went ahead and cut some of it up. As you remember, what we did is we just put it on a nice hot grill.
And it's hot out there, too.
It is hot. I mean, it's smoking hot, and it's so good. But this is good. Depending on the size of your chicken thighs, it's going to take anywhere from 8 to 10 minutes per side. You want to get it so it's, you know, the juices are running clear and the internal temperature is 165. Okay, so now before we go any further, we used to get our E-rolls.
You don't have to roll the R.
I love to roll the R. It's just E-rolls. So we would get to go to this place in Manhattan down around 34th Street, and I tell you they had
the most amazing, but they
They had the best pitas. They did.
Pitas.
And they had
pitas for the gyros. Yeah.
Yes, they had a secret that they did that I have been trying to emulate, and I think I've got it. But this step is not 100% required, but it's one that I think you're going to really want to do, and it's super easy. So what I do is I just get a small skillet, and I'm going to infuse some oil. So I get a quarter cup of extra virgin olive oil, and then I dump in a couple of cloves that I've minced, and then a teaspoon of cloves of garlic. Sorry, that would be important. It's not cloves. Cloves of garlic. And then I put in a teaspoon of dried oregano, a teaspoon of dried
rosemary,
and then a pinch of salt and pepper. And then just let that simmer for about five minutes. And it infuses that oil. And so what Wesley is doing is now we're coating the pitas with that incredible.
It's so good. Just a little extra something.
It is a little extra. I'm going to go ahead and finish chopping and cutting my chicken. Right, but we've also got
I'm going to put some of this on your chicken too.
Good. Yeah, right. Finish it off on the chicken. That's a really, really incredible flavor.
Right. All right.
And just give this chicken a rough cut like I've done right here.
I'm going to put this in here. This is on low.
So I've got my broiler on low, and I've got the rack is about in the middle of the oven. So you got to really watch this.
You don't want to
burn your pitas. We don't want burnt pitas,
right? I hate burnt pitas. And I like pitas that don't have a pocket in them.
Right. If you can only get the pocket ones, that's no problem. Okay, so we're going to brush a little of that oil on there. So there's a couple of items, components of this dish that I just say you cannot skip.
Nope.
You can't.
Nope.
And one of those is going to be chicken, because then it wouldn't be a chicken gyro.
Yes.
But the other is tzatziki sauce.
Yes.
So tzatziki is my favorite thing. It's so good. It's so flavorful.
I can put it on everything.
And you often do. So this is how you make it. It's super easy. You start it with the base ingredient is a cucumber. So we just give it a kind of a quick peeling. You have to peel all the skin, and then we slice it down the middle, and then I use a spoon just to scoop out all those seeds. And then this is the fun part: you get a box grater, and you just scrape that cucumber up and down until you get about a quarter cup of shredded cucumber. Then those cucumbers are loaded with water,
so you need to
get all that excess water out of there. So
what do you use?
I use cheesecloth. Just put in a little cheesecloth.
You can use a coffee filter,
anything that's just going to allow you to drain that water out. Squeeze it, and then I do it over a bowl, and then I get another medium-sized bowl, and you dump that cucumber in there, and then you're going to add a cup of Greek whole milk yogurt. I love whole milk yogurt.
Yes.
And then to that, we're going to do some white wine vinegar, and then we're going to add some chopped garlic. We're going to do some dill.
Dill
is super important. It's a tablespoon of chopped fresh dill.
And we're going to brighten it up with some lemon juice.
A whole lemon juice, and then we got a little pepper and a little salt, and then we finish it off with about a tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil.
Yeah.
Mix that all up, and then put it in the fridge to chill. Okay?
And then it's this delicious stuff. I'm just going to want to spoon it up right
now.
Okay. Let me look at this. Okay, those got a little bit.
I mean, keep an eye on them. They get really nice and soft and pliable, and then it's time to eat.
Yes. Look at
okay,
those.
We have it all ready
those
to go.
Those are so nice and toasted.
I know, they're beautiful. So the pita, I mean, the bread is soft to begin with, but the heating it like that just really, really softens it up. These are actually whole wheat pitas that we got, which we love, but that's why they're a little darker in color.
Yes.
But you get with whatever you can go with. So we start, so what we do, Wesley loves to make it feel like we're really getting it from a...
from the vendor, from the street vendor.
Vendor. Mm-hmm. Athens, maybe.
Well, New York stuff.
New York City, sure. So you put the foil
on. Anything. So you can hold it so you don't get messy on the other end.
These things are meant to be a little bit messy.
Okay.
So we put a layer of the tzatziki sauce. Now we're going to really build it up with this incredible chicken. As you saw, I added a little more of that infused oil, as he likes to call it. This is just crazy delicious. Okay.
A little bit there. They're perfect.
Okay, you good?
All right. Okay. And then we're going to put this wonderful
salad on top.
I could eat this just by itself.
I know.
It's so good.
It really is super flavorful.
Actually, you know what you can do? If you have leftover this and you have leftover chicken, you just make a little
chicken salad.
Chicken salad. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, we'll just make
a Greek chicken salad.
So this, we would literally go into this place and our favorite Eero place, and they were so huge. The Eeros that they would give you, literally, you'd be like, okay, well, thanks. It's like luggage, you know, but...
I loved it.
We ate it.
Good eating.
It was good eating.
All right.
I'm going to move this out of the way so I can get mine in front of me.
No problem. All right.
You know, I got to also say, this is so much fun to serve. Whenever we can all finally get back together, talk about an awesome thing to serve to friends and family as a party. You can make a lot of this, put it in a chafing dish, and people can make their own. It's kind of like fajitas, but it's just
totally.
So awesome.
Look at that. Look how adorable that is.
Well, it may be adorable, but just wait till you eat it.
I'm so excited. I love chicken Eero so much. I like the lamb, too, but I like the chicken.
I know.
Yes.
The lamb is very traditional. Ugh. Of course, when you go into a Eero place, they've got the big spigot. So
right.
If you really want to go for it, get yourself a spigot. No, just do this.
Totally. All right, I'm going in, folks.
Okay. I'm excited. I love gyros. I'm just going to say it. I'm going to say it. It's a gyro. It's an Eero. Are you transported? It's it, right? I'm not a Greek chef. I'm not a Greek.
It's amazing.
But this is my facsimile of what I think is really good.
It is really, really good.
Really?
Yeah, it reminds me of 34th Street.
Yay! It's a miracle on 34th Street.
It's amazing that, I love the tzatziki. The tzatziki just adds this kind of like a tartness to it and just, it's so fresh.
It is a combination.
That salad is so good.
And talk to me about the chicken.
The chicken. That marinade. The chicken. With the yogurt and the lemon and the garlic. And the
smoked paprika.
This is 100% Luna Proof.
Yes! All right.
Yes,
that's all I need.
Yes.
And I love pita. I just love pita, the bread, pita.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. Mm. New York City. It's just like, my heart.
Yeah. Talk about amazing. A sense memory.
Yes. If anything will bring you back, it's good food. Oh, my gosh.
Now you can get this recipe and many more on howtofeedaloon.com.
We always do these when we're like also really hungry. So I'm just like, I'm gonna go to our social media, like us, share it, and tell all your friends and make these pitas and do us a favor and
stay safe.
Tell each other how much you love each other.
Hug your neighbor. Socially hug, socially distance.
Take care of each other.
Yes, please.
It's especially now more than ever.
Right.
We love you so much.
Eros.
It's Eros. Did you ever know that you were my Eero? Bye, y'all. Hey, everybody.
Hey. Now, if you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel.
That's right. And to get more amazing recipes like this, just click right here.
Click, subscribe, click
it all. Subscribe. Just click and subscribe.